Hello, my name is Thomas Najjar. I'm an acupuncturist here in Austin, Texas. I also teach Qigong and Tai Chi regularly at the West Bank Community Libraries. Today I'm gonna share with you the shortest Qigong form that I know, that I have in my repertoire. It's the shortest one, can be done very quickly, but it's also one of my absolute favorites. I really appreciate this form a lot. As I've touched on in some of the other videos, at these times, it's incredibly important to continue to make time for exercise. Qigong is one of the most beneficial forms of exercise you can do to nourish you, to loosen you up, to get the blood moving, get the heart pumping. It's also great for relieving stress and boosting the immune system, which are all incredibly important these days. So I would encourage you, if you're watching at home, if you don't have a habit already, try to find 10 minutes a day to do a little bit of movement every single day. It's much better to make sure that you do 10 minutes a day rather than say, well, when I work out, I make sure to spend an hour working out. So that's what I'm gonna do, or else I'm not gonna do anything. And then something happens and you don't find an hour to work out that day and you say, okay, well, I'll do it tomorrow. And then something happens that day and you don't find an hour to work out, so you say, I'm gonna do it tomorrow, and that just keeps going, and the next thing you know, 3 or 4 days have gone by and you haven't done any movement. So that's the worst case scenario. So just get in the habit of doing 10 minutes of exercise, 10 minutes of Qigong every day. The best time is right before meals when you're on an empty stomach. So this particular form is called Eight Directions Qigong. When I first started teaching Qigong, I was working with a chronic pain group, and one of my colleagues shared this with me and said, hey, this is something you can show to folks. Also, sort of a strange story. At the time, unless I somehow misunderstood him, he suggested that this was something that he had received this teaching through a high-level individual and was told not to share this or teach this to others. So he asked me to do the same. I immediately discarded that instruction, and I teach this form all over the place. So Gene, if you're watching, please don't be mad at me. This is one of my favorite forms, and I just think it's incredibly valuable, so I shamelessly teach this to anyone who would like to learn it. The other thing I'll say about this form, I mentioned this already, it's very short. You can do a full round of this form in less than a minute. And so what I like to do with this form is sometimes I'll use it as a warm-up, sometimes I'll use it on its own. And you can just do as many rounds of this as you want to within 5 or 10 minutes. I just did this the other day. I was driving somewhere and, of course, got wound up in traffic, and I got to my destination and I was going to be meeting with a client, and I needed to make sure that I was in my own sort of calm and serene state, and I certainly was not. So I had 5 minutes before the client showed up, so I just did a couple of rounds of these, and it has an incredible effect on your state and just getting you into a calm and relaxed place. So Eight Directions Qigong. You want to have, as in all Qigong forms, a comfortable stance, slight bend in the knees, okay? And also in this one, you can think about just ever so slightly tucking your tailbone down. Now, you certainly don't want to do anything where you're rounding and you just lose all of your form through your back. But also, as you're sinking slightly in your stance, it doesn't have to be a big sink, it can just be a small one. What you don't want is your butt to kind of stick up and out. So that's what that kind of tucking the tailbone down, so that your pelvis stays more or less level, okay? First movement, with an inhale gathering, exhale ascending. Inhale expanding, exhale contracting, inhale inward, exhale outward, inhale descending, and exhale dispersing. Again, inhale gather, exhale ascending, inhale expanding, exhale contracting, inhale inward, exhale outward, inhale descending, and exhale, dispersing. Okay, so a few details on this form. I just dove right in there, so hopefully you were able to follow along. But there's a few minor points, some points of emphasis that I'd like to touch on. First, you notice that the movements come in pairs. So we have an ascending, we have a descending. We have an expanding, we have a contracting. The very first movement and the very last movement form a pair. So gathering and then dispersing. Okay. This gathering movement, it's a sort of a subtle thing. It has less to do with the mechanics or the physical movement in itself, and it has more to do with your intention, or you could think also the energetic of the movement. With this movement, with this form, what I'm doing is through the palms of my hands, I'm connecting with the chi of the earth in a gathering motion. I also like to think of this as, I have an image in my mind of, with my hands, gathering up handfuls of tall grass, okay? So that's something you can think about. Again, the physical movement is not as important as simply kind of getting that expression and connecting with the chi of the earth. And then similarly, when you get to the end, you have a dispersing motion, which is almost like spreading chi out, letting it flow from your palms, sort of showering the earth with them. The image that was shared with me when I learned this form is showering the earth with gold flakes. So again, just think about the imagery, add the imagery into the movement and your intention, and that'll start to help you get in touch with the texture or the spirit of the movement. So we'll do two more rounds and then I'll add some additional detail. First movement, inhale, gather. Exhale, ascending. Inhale, expanding. Exhale, contracting. Inhale, inward. Exhale, outward. Inhale, descending. And exhale, dispersing. Inhale, gather. Exhale, ascending. Inhale, expanding. Exhale, contracting. Inhale, inward. Exhale, outward. Inhale, descending. And exhale, dispersing. Okay, a few other details that I'd like to touch on. We have this ascending movement and we end up with this shape. This shape where we have a soft curve running down the length of the arm from the shoulder through the elbow, the wrists are bent, the hands are soft and cupped, and the fingertips are pointed towards each other. This is a shape that you will see in many different forms of Qigong. In fact, one practice is simply to stand like so for as long as you can. And I wanted to touch on this shape because there are a couple aspects of it that are very important. One is that you want to make sure that those shoulders stay down, that you're not hunching the shoulders up in any way. Also the elbows, you want to have the elbows dropping. You don't want to have the elbows lifted up. This rotation in the shoulder will start to load tension. So you want to keep the form as relaxed as possible. And then this shape you maintain more or less down the length of the arm as you do your expanding. Right? So with the expanding, you're allowing the chest and the shoulders to open. It's not something where it's just in the arms, right? You want to make sure that the chest expands. You have some expression through the chest as well. Okay? And then that shape maintains as you descend also. So we'll do a couple more rounds of this. Get comfortable in your stance. Inhale, gather. Exhale, ascending. Inhale, expanding. Exhale, contracting. Inhale, inward. Exhale, outward. Inhale, descending. And exhale, dispersing. Inhale, gather. Exhale, ascending. Inhale, expanding. Exhale, contracting. Inhale, inward. Exhale, outward. Inhale, descending. And exhale, showering the earth with gold flakes. Okay, last thing that I'll touch on, one of the more subtle aspects of this form, but also one that when you notice it and start to explore it, actually feels really nice. And that is, I'll turn sideways so you can see. When you're doing something like expanding and contracting, or inward and outward, you can have this rather subtle rocking back and forth, right? So your center of gravity shifts forward and back just a little bit as your arm position changes. So with the arms out, your center of gravity is a little bit further back. So I'll exaggerate. What you end up with is something where you're kind of rocking forward just a little bit and then rocking back. Again, if I'm going inward and outward, there's a sort of gentle lean or rock forward. And then as I extend my arms out, there's that rock back. So that's something that you can incorporate and add as well. Again, just sort of notice it and look for it and enjoy it. But you certainly don't want to do anything where you're exaggerating it and you're struggling to maintain your balance. Or you start to lean forward in your stance or lean backward in your stance. You still want to make sure that you are keeping your torso upright with the tailbone sinking and a little bit of bend in the knees. This is in all forms of Qigong. It's very rare that you have straight legs. There are exceptions to that, of course, but in this particular form, especially, you want to have a little bit of bend in the knees throughout the movement and not have the legs straight with the knees locked out. So we'll do two more rounds. Okay. Inhale, gather. Exhale, ascending. Inhale, expanding. Exhale, contracting. Inhale, inward. Exhale, outward. Inhale, descending. And exhale, dispersing. Inhale, gather. Exhale, ascending. Inhale, expanding. Exhale, contracting. Inhale, inward. Exhale, outward. Inhale, descending. Exhale, dispersing. Again, that was our Eight Directions Qigong, one of my all-time favorite forms. Very easy to learn and memorize. You can do in a very short amount of time. Once again, I encourage everybody to make sure to find time, at least 10 minutes a day, to do a little bit of Qigong. And this is a great form that you can use anytime you feel a little bit wound up, a little stressed out. Great way to just do a little bit of movement, start to regulate your breath, and calm yourself down. All right, thank you very much for watching.